If you're interested in electronics or want to learn electronics, I'll not only show you a 3D print for holding the battery box on a snap circuit, but I'll show you how you can use Tinkercad to simulate circuits and then produce something that'll allow you to make a shield for an Arduino. I'll show you all the steps on today's Filament Friday. This video is sponsored by PCB Way. PCB prototype the easy way with a full-featured custom printed circuit board prototype service from PCB Way. Filament Friday is also brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. Many years ago, I wrote this book, Arduino, A Beginner's Guide to Programming Electronics. It's got like 13 projects to help you get started learning electronics and programming. After this book was released, Snap Circuits came out with this, Snappino. It's got an Arduino module in it, plus all the components and the manual to build 20 projects with the code and everything. It's a great place to start to get a kid started with electronics, and that's really a kid from 5 to 95 years old because it's a lot of fun to play with, and under $50, very, very affordable. And now with Tinkercad, the same software I use to design all my 3D prints, you can do circuits. You can build a circuit, you can write the code, you can simulate it, and then when you're ready, transfer the code to this and actually run it on hardware. It's really a great platform to learn electronics. So while I was 3D printing something for this, I found another feature. So let me tell you the whole story, how I got from here to an Arduino Shield. This is how it started. I had a loose battery box, so I went into Tinkercad and designed a new bracket to hold the battery box. This thing will just snap into the base of the snap circuits, just like this, and then the battery box holds in place. So now I can pick this thing up, move it, and the battery stays in place. While I was still in Tinkercad, I wanted to try out the circuits feature. I've used this a few times in the past, but now I wanted to try an actual circuit from this Snappino kit. So I found this one, which they call stoplight, which is basically a traffic light, controls three LEDs and includes the code. So I'm going to build this in Tinkercad. So I click on Create New Circuit, bring in the Arduino, and then I'm going to build this schematic right here. But the pins D9, D10, and 11 that are on the Snappino are on the opposite side. So I need to rotate the Arduino, and I use the rotate tool. So now D9, D10, and 11 are on the bottom. So now I'll bring in my LEDs, first a red one, and then I'll bring in another LED and change the color to yellow. And then I'll bring a third one in and we'll make that one green. And I made sure that the anodes are at the top and the cathodes are at the bottom. Now the snap circuit LEDs have a resistor built in. I need to add them here. So I'm gonna add a 100 ohm resistor to each of these. This would actually work in the computer if I didn't do this, but I wanted it for another reason. I'll show you. So pin 9, pin 10, and 11 are connected to the resistors, and then I'll finish the rest of the connections. And then finally the ground wire coming from the Arduino to all the cathodes of the LEDs. Once I've got this, now I need to write some code to run it. So you click on the code button and you can write in these blocks, which seems easier. And you can also do a mode where it's blocks and text, but I highly recommend you learn the text mode. And that's what the manual gives you in snap circuits. So select the text mode and now you can type it in. Well, I already typed it in. I'm not going to show you that. So I'm just going to paste it in here. And here's the program that was part of the manual. So it's got a delay for 1 second. You set up the connections for your LEDs, make them all outputs. And then here's the loop that controls the green, the yellow, and the red. So we can come up to the top here, click on start simulation, and it's going to run this code and actually light the LEDs, the green, the yellow, the red. The green and the red light for 1 second, the yellow for half a second. So let's change that. Let's make it 2 seconds, because this will run better if I want to build this in snap circuits. So it's 2 seconds on the green, 2 seconds on the red, 1 second on the yellow. So let's take this and build it in the snap circuit. So here's the schematic. I'm going to build it. First the Snappino, then the ground bus, connect that to ground, then the LEDs, and this actually built quicker than building it on the computer, and it was a lot more fun. So there's a schematic. Now I need to get the code. For that, I launched the free IDE for Arduino on my computer, and then I connect the USB cable that comes with the Snappino kit to the computer. Now I'm not going to retype the code. I'm just going to copy it from Tinkercad and then paste it into the Arduino screen on my computer. So I'll just highlight all this, paste it in place, and then I can actually click on verify to make sure I didn't screw anything up, and it compiled with no errors. So we're good. So now I have to make connections, proper connections to the Arduino. So I'll go up to Tools, and I'll select the Arduino board, and then also select the proper port that I'm connected to, the USB port, and we're ready to upload. So I click on the upload button, it compiles again, and then programs the snappino, and here it is, the same program running in actual hardware on the snappino setup. And here's where it gets really interesting. In Tinkercad, you can export the circuit. You're exporting the eagle.brd file, or circuit board layout file. So I can download this, and then open Fusion 360, another 3D printing tool, and say new electronic design. Then I click on this icon here at the right, and that's gonna bring in the board file. I select it from my computer, and there's the one I downloaded from Tinkercad. I open it up, and here it is. All this, the board layout for a shield, all the components, the rat's nest showing the connections. So now all I have to do is place the components where I want them on the shield, and then I just need to make connections to them. So once I got all the components in place, then I laid the traces to make the connections, and then I moved from design to manufacturing with Fusion 360, and I select the CAM processor. And here's where it produces all the files in RS-274X Gerber format. The top layer, bottom layer, the drill file, everything I need. So I click on export as .zip and process the job and download that file. Now I can take those files, and because I have a PCBmill from Bantam Tools, I can load it into their software and I can mill this board. And that's what I did here. I just milled the board using this tool. And here's the result. It's just a single-sided board. It came out really good. So I'm going to put the components in this and build up my shield. I had all the components in my electronics lab, and here's the finished shield all soldered up with all the LEDs. So now let's plug this back into Snappino, which is already programmed, and there it is running with all the extra components. In fact, I could plug this directly in to a regular Arduino, and it works just fine. And you don't have to have an expensive PCB mill to do this. You can do it with a low-cost CNC. I'm working on a video to show you how to do that. But even cheaper, go to PCBWay.com. You can get 10 circuit boards for $5 from PCBWay.com. Just use those same files, upload them to PCBWay.com, and get 10 boards for $5. Check them out, PCBWay.com. I know this wasn't a typical Filament Friday where I give you a bunch of 3D printing tips, but everything you're learning about 3D printing can easily apply to other maker technologies such as electronics, CNC, and making products. So you can CNC a board after you've done the electronics and maybe 3D print a case and actually produce a product you can sell. There's so many things you can do once you understand how this technology works. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.